After a year, I applied. In fact, it's the only job I've ever applied for. I didn't get it. So I applied to go to Macquarie College. And the reason I wanted to go abroad was because my residential scholarship was for 4 years. And so for my last year, I had to borrow money. And so here I was on a pittance of a salary and big debts and just got married. And I knew I couldn't live with this. So I had to emigrate. And so I tried to go to Uganda, failed, but they offered me a job in Singapore. So that's where I went. So for 3 years I was in Singapore, earning enough money to pay off my debts. And incidentally, this is one reason why I'm so passionately against young people being saddled with debt as they are today at the start of their careers. I think it's just abominable. Anyway, a bit of politics. Singapore, I learned to teach more. It's quite interesting. You start off, it's a polyglot community, mainly Chinese, but there's Indians of various types, and there's Malays, of course. And you start off, and everybody is vaguely browner than you are. And then you gradually learn to recognize the Chinese and the Tamils and the Sikhs and Malays and so on. And you're aware of the differences. And then after about a year, you don't notice them anymore. All you notice are the ones you like and the ones you don't like. So you become sort of colorblind, which I found an interesting experience in retrospect. And incidentally, I was teaching these youngsters, medical students, and I was trying to teach some human physiology by making them do experiments on themselves. Now, you were talking a moment ago about passing a nasogastric tube. So one of the experiments I did was to get the students to pass a tube on each other or on themselves so that they could sample their gastric secretion and so on. And it was fascinating. The Chinese could just dunk, no problems. All the others, the Indians, the Malays, they gagged and choked. It's a clear difference between different people. I did research and I lost my way. I became so obsessed with what I was trying to do was measure or find out whether viscosity changes in the blood depending on whether the gut was absorbing water, fluid, or secreting. And so I thought I could detect this if I measured pressure-flow relations. And so I got absorbed in all the engineering and the maths, and I completely and utterly, the whole thing was far away beyond my skill or capacity. So what I did learn there was not how to do research, but how not to do it. And I learned, I think, the most important lesson of my life, which is in research, it is impossible to make an experiment too simple. And that really what you have to do is take a problem and see if you can break it down to smaller problems. And if you get a problem, you know this, that is almost moronically simple, seems hardly worth asking. The only thing you don't know is the answer, but you know it's a question which is answerable. And then you've got yourself an experiment.